بسم الله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وسلم. اللهم وفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه يا رب العالمين. ان شاء الله before I start the class we need to make regulations for the class, inshallah, for the lesson especially. The question is that you can ask must be relevant to the lesson that we are taking that time. And no comments at all. Otherwise, those comments, they will mess up the whole lesson, inshallah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. باب من الشرك لبس الحلقة والخيض ونحوهما لرفع البلاء أو دفعه. هذا باب, this is the chapter, من الشرك, from the shirk, is لبس الحلقة, wearing a circle, something which is circle that you have, you know, some of the people they see, put around their hands.
Bracelet.
Yeah, that one, what do you call it, the circle
bracelet.
One?
Bracelet.
Yeah, that one. وَالْخَيْضِ and the thread, وَنَحْوِهِمَا and anything like that, لِرَفْعِ الْبَلَاءِ for removing the test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أو دفعه, أو preventing the bala or the test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the scholars, when they explaining this bab, they said this chapter is very important, and every Muslim should put his trust into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you put that something which is like the shape of a circle on your hands, or a thread, and something like that, it depends on the intention you are putting them on your body. If it is removing the test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or you are trying to prevent it from happening, that will be a shirk. Because who can, subhanallah, who can protect you from harm? It's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so many Muslims, you will see them nowadays, they have some objects on their hands, believing that these objects have a special power and they can protect you from evil eye, from black magic, from jealous and envy and everything. So believing in that itself is shirk. But if the person has a full trust into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he doesn't believe that this object can help him, it will be a shirk al-asghar, a minor shirk. And as we mentioned before, minor shirk is worse than the major sins.
Yeah.
Subhanallah. So minor shirk is worse than killing innocent person, drinking alcohol, committing zina. It's worse than that. So the minimum sin you fall into is a minor shirk. So
I have a question, right? It's due to the topic.
Yes.
Let's say, for example, you know, some people, they don't know Ayatul Kursi. They memorized.
Okay.
Let's say they put a sticker on their car. They're okay. Driving.
Okay.
and they think that it protects them.
Okay.
Is that shirk?
No, that one is not shirk because you have Quran. So the Quran, the Salaf, they never put the Quran and hang them, the Quran, some parts of the Quran, they never hung them inside their houses. So that was not there. They never did that. But it's not shirk because this is the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said when he was talking about the Quran, وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين. We send down from the Quran something that is healing and medication for the believers. ولا يزيد الظالمين إلا خسارة. And it doesn't increase the wrongdoers except a loss. So, but it's not something that it's not something good. You better memorize the Ayatul Kursi and say it by yourself instead of a piece of paper written or in a surah putting inside the car. It's not.
Sorry, continue from that. It's related to the topic. You know, sometimes you go into people's houses and they have like same thing like this, you know, like interior design.
Mm.
They might have an eye on the wall, or maybe they have a frame with like, you know, surahs. Is that the same?
It's the same because the Quran. Subhanallah, it's Quran. Why did Allah send down the Quran?
For us to learn,
to reflect on it, and to contemplate, and to practice in our life.
Not
the Quran, it's not the decoration. But most people, they take it as a decoration. They just keep everywhere you go, Surah Yasin, you go another room, Ayatul Kursi, you go, Surah Ibn Nasr. They, subhanAllah, this is very strange.
Sorry, what's the title for today's lesson?
Min ash-shirk, lubsul hilqati, from the shirk is wearing
bracelets,
wal khayt and thread, wa nahuhima and something like that, li raf'i al-bala'i, for removing the test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, aw daf'ihi, aw preventing from happening.
Shirk is bid'ah.
Yeah, it will be here. Yes, because the Salaf, they never done it. وقولوا تعالى الله said in the Quran قل أفرأيتم ما تدعون من دون الله إن أرادني الله بضر هل هن كاشفات ضره. This is a direct question from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's asking us. And Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, قُلْ أُوْ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ سَيْ أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. Can you give me any information? What, anything that you call upon other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? إِنْ أَرَادَنِيَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended something bad to happen to me, هَلْ هُنَّ كَاشِفَاتُ دُرِّهِ. Are these things able to prevent me from having such harm? The answer is what? They can't do anything.
Sorry to go back to this. For wearing the bracelets and believing that it can help you, that's shirk.
That's shirk, yes.
Major or minor?
Yeah. It will be minor or major. It depends on your intention.
Okay.
If you believe this one has got a special power, can help you, prevent from evil eye, from sihir, from black magic, from all this, it will be a major shirk.
And when is it a minor shirk?
When you just wear it, but you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has got everything for me, but this one is one of the, it's an asbab, like a reason.
It's like a root. Okay,
yes.
So that's when it's a minor shirk.
That one is minor shirk.
And minor shirk is worse than major shirk.
Yeah, and minor shirk is worse than the major shirk. Yeah, major. So this is the Quran. قُلْ say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever we mention the name of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what should we do? We have to say what?
Sallallahu alayhi
wa sallam, yes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and verily if you ask them, who created the heavens and the earth, surely they will say Allah has created them. Tell me then, the things that you invoke besides Allah. ما تدعون من دون الله. Tell me the things that you invoke besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إن أرادني الله بضر. Tell me then the things that you invoke besides Allah. If Allah intended some harm for me, هل هن كاشفات ضره. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, could they remove his harm? The answer is no. They are very weak. They cannot do anything. And I know some people, what they do, they go to the seashore, they take bottle of sea water. They bring to their house and they hang it in front of the house. And what's going to happen after 2-3 years, the bottle will be, because it's locked, it will have a lot of fungus inside it. And then they will see, look, this bottle of the seawater is doing its job. How many evil eyes it protected. What's inside is the evil eyes, the black magic, the envy, all the bad things that the people wanted to do to us is inside here. SubhanAllah. I have seen that one. In some areas, SubhanAllah, in every household, they have a bottle of seawater. And some people, what they do, they have rabbit leg hanging inside the car. It has special power to prevent the evil eyes. So these people, they don't have any confidence to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
I was going to say, Sheikh, in Masr, I used to see everywhere I went.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if it's exclusive to Egypt itself or other countries do it, but it was like a string and it had a blue thing.
Okay.
A blue eye. It was
okay.
Like a circle, a blue eye, and it was white, and then it had a black dot. And every time when I ask someone, it says it's they put it outside their house to protect them from evil eye.
Mm. I think it's Turkish. That's right, Turkish.
Yeah.
So it's a Turkish. It's Turkish.
Yeah. Some they have, SubhanAllah, they have that rabbit leg. I don't know what rabbit leg can do. Sea water. These people, they totally forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have trust into other things. SubhanAllah. An Imran bin Hussein radiallahu anhu, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رأى رجلا في يده. عن عمران بن حسين was one of the great companions of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. عمران بن حسين رضي الله عنه. أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رأى رجلا that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم saw a man في يده who had in his hand حلقة من صفر. He had a yellow, what was it?
Brass bracelet.
He had that one. فقال, then the Messenger said to him, ما هذه? What is this? What is this you have on your hands? قال من الواهنة. He said, I put it on my hands. واهنة is an illness that happiness inside the veins of the hands. فقال, then the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, انزعها, remove it. See, this is an order from the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said to him, remove it. فإنها لا تزيدك إلا وهنا. Indeed, it will only increase you weakness. Instead of
helping you
with shifa, it will only increase you weakness. then this is the subhanallah. Look at what the messenger sallallahu says to him. فَإِنَّكَ لَوْ مِتَّ, indeed if you died, وَهِيَ عَلَيْكَ, while it is on your hands, مَا أَفْلَحْتَ أَبَدًا, you would not have succeeded. That means you will never be of those who go to Jannah or who have success and Iman in Islam. Subhanallah. It's very heavy. رواه أحمد بإسناد لا بأس به. This hadith is narrated by Imam Ahmad رحمه الله تعالى. And the Sheikh said the isnad, the chain of narration is sound and it's okay. So what about our communities, the Muslim communities? And now even this kind of stuff is a booming business. I don't know if you are, they even open TVs, TV channels who advertise these things
protection.
As a protection, and they are making millions of dollars from the Muslims, subhanallah. So this is a very bad situation for the Muslim Ummah. See what the Messenger said to Imran bin Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he asked him, what is this? He said, "Min al-wahina, I had a problem inside the vein, one of my veins, and I just wore it as a shifa." And the Messenger said to him, "Inzi'ha, remove it. فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَزِيدُكَ إِلَّا وَهَنًا. Indeed, it will only increase you ضعف, weakness." Then the last bit of the hadith is so heavy. He said to him, لَوْ مِتَّ وَهِيَ عَلَيْكَ مَا أَفْلَحْتَ أَبَدًا. If you die while you have this thing on your head, you will never be successful. Subhanallah. وَلَهُ عَنْ عُقْبَةَ بِنْ عَامِرٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ مَرْفُوعًا وَلَهُ أي عمران بن حسين رضي الله عنه عن عقبة بن عامر رضي الله عنه مرفوعا. عقبة بن عامر is another hadith. He said this hadith is from the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. The messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من تعلق تميمة فلا أتم الله له. من تعلق, whoever hangs or puts تميمة. Tamima is the ta'weez. You know ta'weez? Is these things that they put around the neck of the children, or women have it, or even they put around the necks of the animals like cows, goats, sheep. Some they put on the camels, some they put on their horses to protect them from evil eye.
Ta'weez.
Yeah, ta'weez. So what the Messenger of Allah said, man ta'allaga tamimatan, whoever puts tamima, ta'weez, on his any part of his body or any part of his animal, فَلَا أَتَّمَّ اللَّهُ لَهُ. The Messenger ﷺ has cursed. Dua alayhi, he said, فَلَا أَتَّمَّ اللَّهُ لَهُ. May Allah not give him from that ta'weez what he intended for. Subhanallah. So what do you expect? The Messenger ﷺ is saying, فَلَا أَتَّمَّ اللَّهُ لَهُ. May Allah not give him anything from that ta'weez. ومن تعلق وداعة, and whoever puts وداعة is something that they take from the sea, is something which is found inside the sea, and they put it like the same like the ta'weez. فلا ودع الله له. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not give him any thing from that وفي رواية من تعلق تميمة whoever puts on his body تميمة the تعويذ فقد أشرك indeed he has committed شرك رواه أحمد والحاكم so and this تعويذ سبحان الله they have a special TV channel now it's a booming business that Muslims will be standing in queue in order to get those kind of ta'weeze. I know when I was young, the people, they used to call him Sheikh, but he was not Sheikh. Later on in my life, I found out that he was completely fake. He did not have the knowledge. He did not know Arabic language. He did not memorize some juice of the Quran. He didn't know the Quran, he didn't know Hadith. He was just like crazy man. And the people, they call him like Sheikh. So what he used to do was, subhanAllah, very funny. He will go to every houses in the area. And if he sees a young child or a young boy or a girl just running here and there, he will call and he will do this. Oh, he has no blood in his body. The evil يعني, spirits, they have sucked all his blood out. Yeah. And then the poor mother will say, what, Sheikh, what happened? Said, the spirits, they have sucked out all his blood. Then he will say, you have to slaughter a big sheep and give me such and such. Then she will slaughter the sheep. She will give him a lot of money. In that way, he has built so many houses. He has got SubhanAllah, too much money. Because these people, they believe in him. So what he will do when he does this, he will check, like a doctor in his eyes, he will say, oh, no blood in his body. His evil spirit has sucked out all his blood. So what he will do, he will write down this ta'weez. One day I opened some of the ta'weez. Inside is all the Arabic letters in different directions.
Shapes.
Different directions. 20 qaf is facing that side. 200 qaf facing that side. Some facing up, some facing down. Yeah, well, you never know what they are. Then he will put them and they will tie them on the child's neck. SubhanAllah. And the people, they believe in him because there was no da'wah, there was no people who were giving tawheed, subhanAllah. So these people, they are very dangerous. فَقَدْ أَشْرَكْ has indeed committed shirk. Whoever puts tamima, ta'weez, on his body, on his animal, has committed shirk. So what are we supposed to do? We have to put our trust into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the one who can protect you from evil eye, jealous, black magic, anything. What did Nabiullahi Musa said? هو الذي يطعمني ويسقين. Or Ibrahim عليه السلام. هو الذي يطعمني ويسقين. Allah is the one who feeds me and who gives me water. وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين. And when I fall sick, Allah is the one who cures me. Allahu Akbar. This is the proper aqidah that we should be on. So, this hadith is narrated by Imam Ahmed. SubhanAllah. Wali Abi Ibn Abi Hatim an Hudayfata Hudayfa bin Yaman رضي الله عنه أنه رأى رجلا that صحابي حذيفة he saw a man في يده خيط in his hand was a thread من الحمى he worn it because of high fever فقطعه he cut it off who cut it off the صحابي the companion he cut it off when he saw this he cut it off وترى قوله قوله تعالى he read وما يؤمن أكثرهم بالله إلا وهم مشركون. He recited this verse. He said وما يؤمن أكثرهم بالله, majority of them do not believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى إلا وهم مشركون, except that while they are committing shirk. So this is the action of the Sahabi, and the Sahabi will not do anything like this unless he has seen the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, or he has got a knowledge from the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Mm-hmm. Is that minor or major shirk?
It's a major shirk. Major. Yeah.
Or on an animal as well?
Yeah, and anything. So sihr is a kufr. Black magic is a total kufr. It's a disbelief. So that one is a major, major sin. We know the hadith, سبع المبغاض, the seven destructive elements that the Messenger of Allah said, اجتنبوا سبع المبغاض. Keep away from the seven destructive elements or major, major sins. Ashirku billah, and then wasihr, black magic. So it's one of the major, major sins. So black magic is very, very dangerous. So now our Muslim community is doing these things. They are having this ta'weez. They have bracelets, as we mentioned, they have threads on. Where is Allah then? Where is the trust of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So we have to, they need a help from us. If you see anything like this in your community, in your family, advise them. And not, you don't need to be harsh to them. Like if you go to them and remove, then they may fight back. But just advise them, give them da'wah, this is, tell them the hadith, inshallah, with kindness, inshallah. فيه مسائل الأولى التغليظ في لبس الحلقة والخيض ونحوهما لمثل ذلك. التغليظ, that it was emphasized, it's highly forbidden, means it's highly forbidden, لبس الحلقة والخيض, wearing the bracelets and the thread and anything which is like that. الثانية, second one, أن السحابي لو مات وهي عليه, if that companion, if he died while he had it, he had on his body, ما أفلحا, he would not have been a successful person. فيه شاهد لكلام الصحابة أن الشرك الأصغر أكبر من الكبائر. And we also understand and learn from this that shirk al-asghar is worse than the al-kabair or the major sins.
So, Sheikh, does that mean like wearing rings, like jewelry, is that wrong?
Huh?
So, do you know people they wear jewelry?
Uh-huh.
And like ring.
Okay.
Gold, silver ring.
If okay.
They marry, they wear ring. Is that wrong?
The ring, yeah?
Yeah.
No, that's one is haram. The gold one is haram.
Okay.
If it's gold, gold's not allowed.
It says here the strict forbidden is wearing rings.
Huh?
It says number one. But I think it's in relation to the explanation of the belief. Right. So if you believe that this thing has anything to do with it.
Yeah. No, the ring, the normal one, the message is he had a ring. So you can have a ring, a silver one, but not
gold one.
Not gold one, yeah. الثالث أنه لم يعذر بالجهالة. He was not excused because of being جاهل. Because the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم told him to remove it. And when Hudhayfa saw that man with the bracelet on his hand, he commanded him to remove it. Because those people, they had iman. When you tell them, they will remove it. But nowadays, maybe they will say to me, hey, Mawlana, you know, do you have more knowledge than that. He is the one who gave me this ta'weez. Subhanallah. الرابعة أنها لا تنفع في العاجلة. It will not help you in this world. بل تضره but it will harm, it will only harm. لقوله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تزيدك إلا وهنا. It will not, it will only increase you weakness. الخامس number 5 الإنكار بالتقليد على من فعل مثل ذلك. الإنكار بالتقليد. So the Sheikh is saying الإنكار بالتقليد that we have to
be harsh,
to deny harshly يعني على من فعل مثل ذلك, whoever does like that. But now it's, if the, these people are so jahil, we need to be soft inshallah. السادسة التصريح بأن من تعلق شيئا وكل إليه. Whoever puts something on his body, like on his neck or on the, and you know, subhanallah, I remember this is something, subhanallah, it will blow your mind. Women, some countries, when she has a baby, she delivered a baby tonight, she will take a knife and put under the pillow of the baby until that child becomes like 1 year. She will have that big knife under her pillow. So when you ask them, what is this knife doing here? Why do you have a knife under your pillow? Why? You say, no, this pillow is going to protect the jinn, the evil eye. Subhanallah. And what they don't understand is another child may come, take the knife of an, kill the baby. They don't know. But as a culture, they have it. Subhanallah. Even when I was young, I told some woman, please, fear Allah. Why you, this knife would only may kill your child. No, what, that, ask that sheikh. They call everyone sheikh. That one, you know, he prescribed it for me.
Which country is this?
Where are you from? Me.
Sheikh, you know, sorry, you know the court thing?
Yeah.
That happened to my friend, he's from Pakistan, and some woman would measure a cord. So let's say he was like 10 years old or something. The woman would measure the cord according to the length of his body, and she would cut the cord, and she'd give it to him, she'd wrap it around, and every time he took the cord off, he'd get a headache, and then when he put the cord back on, he'd be okay. And then and his mother and father, Allah Mustafa, I don't know, they allowed it for some reason. Allah. And then only when his brother said, look, this is shirk, they got rid of the cord. I don't know if it's in every culture, but I know it happened to him.
They do it. And some women, when they get a baby, they also, like, not silver and gold. And what is that other one? The red one?
Brass or something.
Yeah, that one.
Bronze.
Yeah, the bronze.
Yeah.
They have a long bronze around her waist. So these people, I don't know, they don't have any trust into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Sheikh, you know, like the so-called sheikh does the magic.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't he not have to like speak to the shaitan, like the jinn, to do it?
Yeah, definitely. He has a relationship with the shaitan. Yeah. He will not be able to do any black magic unless he has got a relationship with the jinn.
How did he contact?
What did he do? There are some books that, one is called Tahdhir al-Arwah.
Yeah.
It's called Inviting the Spirits.
Yeah.
So if you read that book, you can invite all the jinns. They can come to your house. Oh. I really love that jinn. السابعة التصريح بأن من تعلق تميمة فقد أشرك. It has all been openly said, anyone who puts on his body or on his animal tamima, ta'weez, faqad ashraka, yas, associated and subscribed partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means he committed shirk. الثامنة أن تعليق الخيط من الحمى من ذلك. Having a thread on your body because of high fever is also the same. التاسعة تلاوة حذيفة الآية دليل على أن الصحابة يستدلون بالآيات التي في شرك. When حذيفة رضي الله عنه bring دليل like this verse, it shows that the Sahaba they were bringing evidence for if someone does a shirk, they would bring evidence from the Quran. من الشرك الأكبر على الأصغر. So he bring the this verse which is talking about the major shirk on the minor shirk. كما ذكر ابن عباس في آية البقرة. العاشرة أن تعليق الودع من العين من ذلك. So this wadع, they call it wadع, is something they it's found in the sea. It has got a line like that.
Seashell. And when you put it to your ear, you can hear the ocean.
Yeah, that one.
Seashell.
Yeah.
Seashell.
See, what do they call it?
Shell.
Seashell. Yeah, the shell. Yeah, the shells. That one. Subhanallah. So if you have a seashell on your ears because of evil eye, it's also a shirk al-azghar. It depends on the intention. If you believe that it's the savior, it's blessed, then it will be a major one. الحادي عشر بإلبن الدعاء على من تعلق بالتميمة أن الله لا يتم له. That the Messenger of Allah made a curse, he curse on anyone who puts the ta'weez on his body. ومن تعلق وداعة فلا ودع الله له أي ترك الله له. And whoever has that seashell on his body, Allah will leave him between him and his seashell. So let him see what the seashell can do for him. So Allah, that is today, the lesson is very short.
Shall I have a question?
Okay.
In Egypt, I used to see 90% of the taxis, depending on if they were Christian or Muslim. If they were Muslim, 90% of the taxis they used to get into, they used to have a Quran, like a kitab, in the front of the car.
Okay.
They put it in the front. I don't know if you've seen it before. But all the Qur'ans, every time you go in there, it gathers dust. You know, it's not for reading purposes. And I don't know if I ever asked, but I assume I got the assumption that they put it there for some sort of protection. The actual mushaf.
It's full of dust. That shows they've never been, and they never read.
It was just there, always at the front of the car, like in the dashboard.
So we can assume that they are just having it as a barakah.
Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah.
Is that haram, or is that like a form of like, because the assumption that I got in my head was they believe that the kitab itself, or the Quran itself, is the one that's protecting them, and maybe not Allah.
Subhanallah. So it depends, anyway, it depends on the intention of the person who has the kitab. But the Salaf, they never had Quran. They never bought in on their horses or in their houses as a means of barakah. But the Quran, لِيُنذِرَ مَنْ كَانَ حَيًّا, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, to warn for those who are alive. It's warning for all of us. And we have to implement it's the sharia. It's a way of life for all of us to implement how to treat your wife, how to educate your children, how to treat your neighbors, how to eat food, whether you eat halal or haram, or you have to abstain from riba. It's a complete way of life. Not just keep it inside your car and it will protect you. No, that doesn't work that way. But religion has just now become like a culture. Some people, they have it like a culture. I've never been, but some people told me if you go to like Indonesia and Malaysia, women, most of them, what they do, when they come to the masjid, there is a hijab inside the masjid. Can we switch off now? Because now we are just chatting.